Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
It's good to be here tonight. It's the first time I've got to be in this church. Come by here once to be involved, but I didn't get to come in because it was empty then. It's real nice. God has blessed the bread.
Yeah.
I'm so glad. He deserves it. Yes, he's trying to spread the word with all he can. Just pray for me. I've been having a little trouble. My throat getting dry.
Bless.
I'll do the best I can. I hope that's what my songs got something somebody needs to hear. That's what I told my daughter.
Bless.
Maybe something in them songs is the very thing somebody needs to hear. Help me lift them. I just want to be blessed to somebody. Hey, JR?
Yes, ma'am.
I need some papers out in covers. I've got the papers. I don't know the words all over the heart.
That's something bad.
Yeah, bring me all the papers. It takes just a minute, that's all.
Well, I know I've been seen.
Oh,
deliverance.
did get pushed before tonight.
Yeah. Hi. There's more.
Oh, wrong in the whole world. It arrests my heart.
Hey, he's bad.
Raven, stay right here if y'all do.
Do God's home with that?
Sir.
Nights of home?
I'm not prison.
Stacy, you haven't got a song? Say what? You say it, sister.
No, I think it was the noise of you and my kids.
Well, that's good. Well, that young man back there said.
Just want to try one? Just want to try one? That deer in the headlight look bomb? Oops!
Somebody testify, amen.
Still giving me that deer in the headlight look. Amen.
Tired, brother.
It's got to be here tonight, amen.
Amen.
Your glory, where is your glory?
You might want to turn this down just a little bit.
Bless you.
I'm thankful to be here tonight, amen?
Amen.
As you notice, my ear is a little bit better this time, amen?
Good.
So, Lord, save my eardrum, and I'm thankful for that. But you know, Brother John, one day in the land of Egypt, there was an angel of death passed through one night, taking the very firstborn child of male. And everybody had fear on them, because they knew Brother Tommy. But there's an angel come through and said, if you put blood upon the door, I will pass by.
Yeah.
And I believe, Brother Tommy, when they put that blood upon the door, that little young man, he's laying there and he said, Dad, I need to know one thing. Go ahead, brother. I want to know if that blood's still there. Amen? We better make sure that the blood's there tonight. Amen?
Yes.
Number three. Number three. Birds. Amen. It's been good to be here tonight. Amen.
Amen, brother.
Praise God.
Thanks,
brother.
Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
You want to find me?
Jones tonight. Amen. It was requested that I sing this song. And Jeff, I hope you're still watching. This is for you. Amen. Go ahead, brother. See?
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you. Touch you last week. Say the weapon wouldn't be formed, but he said it wouldn't prosper. Amen. So I praise the Lord for
Amen. And you know, Lord God, I've seen over the years that the fear of the Lord has left His house. It seems like, amen. People don't fear Him like they used to. Amen. Lord God, they don't reverence God like they used to. You know, Lord God, people will shout a house down just to praise the Lord. Amen. And the word was always welcome. The word of God was welcome because people were hungry and they were thirsty for the Lord. Amen. But Lord God, nowadays things has changed. But you know what? Lord God, I believe before the Lord comes back, He's going to bring those that's truly got a heart for Him. He's going to bring them together, amen, and they're going to glorify Him with one mouth, yeah. Amen. They're going to lift Him up, amen. And glory to God, and I just thank Him tonight, and I praise Him tonight, because you know He's been good to me, amen. I couldn't make it without my Jesus, amen. I couldn't make it without my Lord, amen. Every single day, I've got to have Him every minute, every second of the day. I got to have Jesus, amen. And I just thank Him, Lord God, for never leaving me, never forsaking me, amen. And I give Him glory tonight, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
I just like to say thank you, Fred. I've been battling cancer for a year now, and the doctors told me I wasn't supposed to be walking. My hips are all eat up cancer, and my liver and all that. God healed every bit of it.
Amen.
So, you know, and I took my last treatment about 2 weeks ago, so I'm fixing to go for a MRI. So, I know what it's going to
be. Amen.
Give Brother Fred a hand. Amen.
Y'all.
said, be your will.
Yeah.
Amen. God knows how to do this.
Amen. Amen. Everybody give the Lord a big hand clap. Go ahead and obey the Lord. You make me quiet.
Come on. Here you go one of these days.
One of these days.
Well, you know, folks, I preached this before, but the Lord has laid this in my heart all week for tonight. And I don't care if I preach the same message 10 times in a row. If God lays on your heart, you got to preach it again. Amen.
Oh, amen.
How many knows to serve the Lord? We got to have faith. How many knows to receive anything from God? It's got to be by faith. You cannot earn the things of God. Now, come on now. Now, I believe in living right. Brother, I believe in living clean. Believe in living best that we know how to live. But you know, that's not what moves God tonight. Faith is what moves God. Faith is what moves. Great works don't move God. But faith moves Him. Amen. Come on now. He will reward you for your works. Don't take me wrong. He will bless you for your works. But that's not what's going to cause God to move for you. What will cause God to move for you is faith. Come on now. Let's go to Hebrews chapter 11. Begin with the first verse. Let's pray first, Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you, we praise you, Lord, for your spirit that we've already felt here tonight, Lord. We thank you for your precious anointing, God, that we felt here tonight, Lord. We thank you for the moving here tonight, Lord. And I just ask, Lord, that you anoint me with your spirit tonight, Lord. I just ask, Lord, that you'll just birth that which you have spoken here tonight. Just birth it forth from me tonight, Lord, and help me, Lord, to declare your word, Lord, in its unadulterated, uncompromised form, Lord. Lord, I don't want people's eyes on me tonight. I want them on Jesus tonight, Lord. So help me to decrease so that you can increase tonight, Lord. And Lord, I give you the glory, I give you the honor, and I give you all the praise because it all truly belongs to you, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hebrews chapter 11, first verse. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Huh? It's the substance, it's the very ingredient of things hoped for. You're going to make a cake, you're going to make the bread, you got ingredients that you mix together to do that. Come on now. When you're mixing that, brother, your hope is to have your cake when it's done. Amen. But it takes them ingredients to mix together to make that cake. Well, it takes faith. It's the very substance for the things that you hope for. It's the very evidence of those things. Come on, not seen.
Amen. Glory to God.
Huh? I'm waiting for deliverance. Power of God's going to flow. This is Sweetwater House of deliverance. And His deliverance power is going to flow. The drug addicts are going to go free. The drunkards are going to go free. All those that's bound by sin is going to go free. Because His deliverance power shall flow. That's what I believe.
Amen.
Huh? Well, you're crazy, preacher. Yeah, I may be, but I'm just crazy enough to believe Jesus. How I stepped outside of the box a long time ago. I stepped outside of it, Brother Bobby, and I realized if I could believe Him, He could do it. Amen. If I could believe Him, if you could believe Him tonight, He can do it. Come on now, folks. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good report. Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Come on now, I work here when He formed this world. I work here when He created everything. But I believe it, brother. By faith I believe that He done it. By His word He spoke it. He said, let there be light, and there was light. Come on now. He spoke it into existence. That's the reason why, children, glory to God, we got to watch our mouths. The Bible says that death and life are in the power of the tongue. We can speak death or we can speak life. We can run around and say, well, I'll never amount to anything. God ain't ever going to move for me. And that's where you're going to be at. But if you start believing His word,
to please God. We've got to have faith, because without it, it's impossible to please God. He cannot be pleased. Glory to God, without faith. It don't matter how many good works you got tonight. It don't matter how many widow women you're going to visit, how the homeless folk you're helping. Come on, I'm just coming down there. Some's going to get mad at me. But coming down, cover, or how many people you're helping, that's all good and great. But if you have not got faith, you're not pleasing God.
Right.
Come on now, folks. Well, preacher, you're going to make a lot of people. I got nothing against good works. That's all awesome. That's all great. But Lord God, anybody can do all those things without faith. They can do those things without faith. There's lost people in the world doing the same things without faith. Come on, if you understand what I'm saying. But when faith's involved, my mind's a different story. When faith's involved, Lord God, them works come to life. Now mind you, faith and good works do go hand in hand. Huh? But you can't have one without the other, brother. Bible says faith without works is dead. It's dead. So they go hand in hand. But the works ain't what pleases him. The works come for faith. The works come because of your faith. Come on now. I live right because I believe in you. I live right because I believe the Bible. I live right because he's dwelling on the inside and gives me what I need to live right. Come on. I can't live right out of my own strength, Johnny, because I will fall on my face. I can't pull myself up by my own bootstraps, or I will fall on my face. But once I get my mind made up, God, I believe in you. I'm going to walk by faith. And I'm going to live according to your word, because I believe in you to help me, God. I may stumble, but I can cry out and get the forgiveness that I need, the mercy that I need, J.R., when I stumble. And I have stumbled, folks. I've not lived a perfect life. I've not lived an absolute perfect life. I have stumbled along the way. But Lord God, he's always been there. He's always been there. And he's never turned me away when I said, Lord, forgive me, for I have sinned against thee. And guess what he does, Brother Bobby? He forgives me. Tonight. I know there's some that can preach it a whole lot better than me. I know there's some that can testify it a whole lot better than me. But I'm doing what God's given me to do. Amen. Huh?
All right.
But without faith, it's impossible to please him, for he that cometh to God must believe that he is. Huh? You got to believe that he is. What do you mean he is? Come on, he is. Huh? He is. What do you mean? He is. What do you mean? He is. Come on now. He is an Alpha and Omega. He is everything, my brother. He is the great I am. He is everything. Come on now. He is. You say, well, then that tell me something here. Well, I'll tell you this. The Bible says that Jesus came in the volume of a book. From Genesis to Revelation. The Bible teaches us that the Word was made God. The Word was God. The Bible teaches that he came in the volume of a book. Genesis to Revelation. Jesus manifested in the flesh. God, I believe there's one God. How many believe there's one God tonight? I know there's one God. Yes, I believe in the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. I sure do, folks. But I believe the Bible says that these three are one. There's one God. He's manifested to us in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. But yet, there's only one God. Come on now. Now, I believe that Jesus was God manifested in the flesh. Glory to God, Jesus, the revelation manifested in the flesh. The Word was with He got angry.
Yes, he did.
He went into the temple. They were buying, they were selling in the temple. Boy, he got angry. He went in there and he flipped the money changers' tables over. He made him a whip and he went to driving them out. Could you see a preacher doing that today? They said, that preacher lost his mind!
Yeah, all
right. Come on now. But he drove them out. He said, it is written that my house shall be called what? House of prayer. But ye have made it a den of thieves. Ooh, glory. Somebody needs to listen tonight. Let's get the glory back in the house. Let's get the glory back in his house. Let's get his glory back in the house. We don't need programs made by man. We don't need all the man-made stuff. Simply what we need is for the Holy Ghost to return back to the house of God. Then people will get what they have needed. The lost will be saved. The sick will be healed. Those who are God that are bound to drugs and alcohol and all these unclean spirits will go free. It will only allow the Holy Ghost of God to come back into the house. Man's been in the way long enough. I seen God want to pour his spirit out, and I've been in some meetings, glory to God. I felt the presence of God in such a mighty way. I felt the presence of God in such a powerful way, glory to God, that I was afraid. People say, I don't understand that. Well, you've been where I've been at those couple of times, you'd understand. I was afraid, Brother Bobby, to make the wrong move. I don't understand that. But glory to God. God's God. And his glory belongs to him. Hey, brother, I seen this too. I seen right when you feel so strong, somebody's flesh, they get excited, Johnny. And they get up and they would quench the spirit. How many times have you seen that over the years? I've seen it with preachers, Bobby. I mean, God's spirit be poured out. God be moving all of a sudden. Pretty well, it's time to make my show. Come on, man. I'm being honest. The next thing you know, the preachers. I ain't got a preacher. That God wants to grab somebody out there, a little preacher. If it's certain, let God, glory to God, let God have his way. If they want to stand and testify, let them testify. There's one thing I believe. Glory to God, there should be liberty in the house of God. There should be liberty, there should be freedom in the house. Amen. There's somebody, glory to God's got a word. Glory to God, burning on the inside. They need to do it. They need to preach. Somebody got a song burning on the inside. They need to sing it. Somebody got a testimony. They need to testify.
Amen.
Come on, folks. I believe the Ten Commandments. I believe they're holy. But you know these can't save you. Did you know that, gentlemen? Now, I respect the Ten Commandments. Now, I believe they need to be in public places. I believe they need to be in public places in the public eye so that people can see. But this right here, the Ten Commandments and the Mosaic Law cannot save you, cannot save me. If it could, Jesus would have not had to came and died for you and I. It's his precious blood that he shed at Calvary. Now that's faith. That's faith. If I'm trying to keep the Mosaic Law, that's me. But if I simply believe, simply believe on the Jesus Christ. That's faithful. Yes, I will repent if I truly believe. And I believe if you, come on now, if you really do believe the Lord, you'll repent. And I believe that's the first step. Huh? You'll repent. Have you ever been in a spot, you know, glory to God, that maybe you've done something wrong, but all of a sudden the love of God just went on you and He loved you so much? Glory to God, I mean, it weren't a whipping He gave you, but He just loved you so much that you just started pouring your heart out and repenting. I've been there, amen. Come on. I've been there. Come on. Now, I know God's a God of wrath, judgment, and all this. I know that. I know He is. But glory to God, I lived in such a fear for a long time, JR, that I could not have a relationship with Jesus because I was too scared of Him.
Yeah,
do you understand now? Don't take me wrong. I do fear Him.
Yeah, they might.
I fear Him.
Oh, yeah.
The Bible says that fear is the beginning of wisdom. The fear of God is. And I fear Him. But I know something. He wants to walk with us, J.R. He wants to talk with us. Just as He did with Adam in the cool of the day.
He desires that walk. How long has it been since you just got like, hey, Lord, it's me. Lord, I'm not here to ask you for anything today.
All I want to do is praise you, Lord.
Amen. Yeah, that's good.
All I want to do is thank you, Lord. But I weren't having that relationship. I was afraid every time I stood up that God was going to kill me. I was afraid every time I slipped up, He was going to kill my loved ones. Now, mind you, I know God's a God of judgment. But, folks, He'd much rather shed forth His love, His mercy, and His grace anyway than His judgment.
And I found out, I heard something.
I heard this. That God weren't out to get me anymore.
And here.
What do you mean? You been born again? He's not angry at you. I preached this last Sunday. But His wrath, His judgment is poured out on Jesus.
So He's not angry at me no more.
Come on. Now, if I get out from under that cover, if I willfully step away from Him, I'm asking for judgment. Do you understand what I'm saying, folks?
I'm talking about you just walking away from God. I'm not talking about you slipping and falling and repenting and getting up. We all have sinned. We all have sinned. Come on now, folks. We all have sinned somewhere down the line. We've had God forgive me. But I'm talking about when you turn your back on Him and you walk off of Him, you slip out from under that cup. Come on. Come on, folks. There's where the judgment can come in. But as long as I'm under that blood, under that covering. Huh? We're safe. We're safe. Come on now, folks. As long as you're under that covering. Come on, folks. I don't believe that. Well, go ahead. Go ahead. That's fine. I don't believe it. It's up to you. It's your choice. But I learned something. I just get quiet. Just get quiet, Brother Bobby. Just get quiet, Brother J.R. If I just get quiet long enough, I can hear the Lord speak. If I just get quiet long enough, He'll tell me what I need to be doing. If I just get quiet long enough, He'll say, Jesus Christ. And I believe in fasting, folks. I've been on fasting. I've been on fasting. The Lord speak to me through His Word. Show me some marvelous things. Again, I guess we still got to believe. Once we fast and we pray, we still have got to believe God. Amen.
Was delivered of a child when she was past age because she
it's God, but to choose to believe God to do it. Huh? Come on now. I'm a strong believer in miracles. I'm a strong believer in healings. I'm a strong believer in what God is able to do. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Through faith also Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed and was delivered of a child when she was past age because she judged him faithful who had promised. Therefore sprang there even of one and him as good as dead, so many as the stars of the sky as the stars of the sky and the multitude and as the sands which is by the sea, shore and newborn. How many knows that you're part of the seed of Abraham? Come on now. Huh? The seed of Abraham. Come on now. Hallelujah. These all died in faith, not having received the promises, but have seen in them afar off, and were persuaded of them, and embraced them, and confessed they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth. For they that say such things declare plainly they seek a country. My. And truly, if they had been mindful of that country from which they came out, they might have had opportunity to have returned. Now listen, folks. It's good to testify and to witness to people from what God's brought you out of and from what God's delivered you from. But don't sit and meditate on that time. Don't sit and meditate when you were doing these things or doing those things. Because I'm here to tell you something tonight. If you ain't careful, the tempter will come on and call you. He'll start saying, you remember them things you used to do? You remember how much fun that you had? Come on, if you be mindful of it, glory to God, you'll have opportunity to return back to it. Folks, don't return back to what God has delivered you from. Don't return back to them beggary elements of the world, that sin-sick world, that sin-sick life that you once lived in. Don't return back to that, but by faith, walk every day. By faith, walk on and live for Jesus. Things. See, now the devil, he likes to whisper, you remember what you know before you got saved, and he likes to condemn some stuff like that. But remember this, when you come to Jesus, the Bible says that you're a new creature. It teaches me, brother, that those old things have passed away. Huh? I'm going to say something that's going to make some mad. But I'm not a sinner saved by grace.
No. So no love you. Listen.
Because I'm a new creature. I was a sinner before I came to him. But once I came to him, I became a new creature. And now his righteousness rests on the inside. His righteousness is upon us because of Jesus. So no, I'm not a sinner saved by grace. We're the righteousness of God through Christ Jesus.
Huh? Come on now.
Come on. Through him. Not myself, but through him. Not through my abilities. Not through your abilities, but through him. Or are you in work? Study it out. You'll find out I'm in the Word. You get in there, you start reading, you'll find out this old preacher's in the Word. Huh? God showed me some things. He had to unprogram me of some teachings over the years. Had to unprogram me of some things that had been placed in me over the years. And reteach me. Huh? Oh, come on. I don't want to get into a lot of things, but folks, let me tell you something. By Bible says to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. How many believe that? But let me tell you something, folks. This is going to get some OT, but you need to read it. You get it and I read it. The Spirit leaves the child of God and goes on to be with the Lord.
There's no suffering, there's no pain, there's no sickness.
But it yet has not got its glorified body. We don't get our glorified body until He returns and brings those that went on back with Him. Then the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we receive the glorified body.
You don't hear that cow all the time.
Come on. Come on. I'm in the Word, folks. Read it. It's there. See, that's what I was taught. Good, I'll get my new body when I get to heaven. Yeah, there'll be no pain. You won't be sick. You won't be bound up. You won't be hurt. But it'll just be your spirit there. Huh? But when He comes back, I'm the dead in Christ. Why you think they rise first? Why you think the dead in Christ rise first? Glory to God. They rise, the dead in Christ rise first. Then we which remain shall be changed in a twinkling.
Yeah, man.
Come on, people.
Come on,
that's right.
And you don't respect. I respect them.
But they erred. They erred somewhere. Come on, that word works. But now they desire a better country that is in and heavenly, wherefore God is not ashamed to be called their God, for He hath prepared for them a city. By faith, Abraham.
It's me, O Lord, standing in the need of prayer. It's me, O Lord, standing in the need of prayer. It's me, O Lord, standing in the need of prayer. It's me, O Lord, standing in the need of prayer.
Why was He going to sacrifice His only son? Well, of course, He got a son of promise. Ishmael, that was the son of promise. That was the work of the flesh. That was them trying to bring about the promise of God.
Come on, there we go.
Trying to bring about the promise of God out of their own ability. That's the reason why we got that mess over in the Middle East now. Because Abraham and Sarah said, go into my handmaiden. And of course, he didn't refuse. He went right on in there. Come on now. And they conceived that child, but he was not the child of promise. Isaac was. Of whom it was said that in Isaac shall thy seed be called. Accounting that God was able.
Now, they believed God.
This is how much he believed God. Accounting that God was able to raise him up even from the dead. From whence also he received him in the figure.
Come on now, folks. He knows. If he sacrificed his son Isaac, he know that God cannot lie. He know that God will not lie. He knew if he sacrificed Isaac, that God would have to raise him from the dead.
But God had prepared for him a sacrifice. A ram caught. In a thicket.
My. But he was going to see, let me tell you something.
He weren't playing around, he was going to do it. He was going to do it. Come on, folks. God speaks to you. Obey. Obey is faith. He may tell you to go start a church in a place that a lot of people says, well, it can't happen. Come on, tell. They may tell you to go start a church in a place that says it's way off. There ain't no way nobody will come. But you got to obey and go do it. I'm going to have folks here. God's going to feel this place. God's going to feel it. He's going to feel rise. He's going to feel it. I know it's painful. Brother Jay, I wouldn't go every week. And I wouldn't battle the battles that I had to battle every single day of my life. The devil coming at me, some fashion, some form, Brother Bobby. I wouldn't battle that. I wouldn't battle it every single day.
Come on.
Bobby. 220, 230 beats a minute.
Hey.
I thought she's having a heart attack. I thought she's dying. All I know to do is pray and get others to pray. But then that peace came. And every time he gives me that peace, every time I feel it, don't matter how bad the storm's raging, when I feel that peace, I know that everything's going to be all right.
He's faithful.
Yes, he is. I've been called everything under the sun, false prophet, you name it. I've been called everything. Everything. But he's been faithful, Stacy.
Yes.
And I'll tell you, it's the same as I told him in Roswell. This is how I feel about it. I truly, if I'm fake, if I'm a false prophet, I want God to just strike me dead right here before you. I'm serious, folks. I wouldn't be doing this if I didn't know it. I wouldn't be doing this if I didn't believe he called me, brother. I'd rather sit right back there with you all and listen to the preacher. But if I be fake, may God strike me down right now before you all and all that's watching tonight or will be watching. That's the way I feel about it. If I'm fake, I don't want to live, brother. If I'm a false prophet, I don't want to be here. But I know I'm not. I know I'm not. Well, that's a problem. No, that's just believing God. That's what it is. That's believing God, folks. You got to believe God that he's called you. If you don't believe he's called you, there ain't going to be nobody else out there to encourage you. Hardly ever, let me tell you. There'll be a lot that'll try to tear you down. There'll be a lot that'll try to pull you down.
That's just
but you got to believe him.
That's
you still, I'm still talking about faith. Without faith, it's impossible to please him. Get us an olive oil, JR, if you don't care your songs. So please, we're going to have an altar call. If anybody feels like they need to come to altar and have a word of prayer with the Lord, come on. The altar's always open. It's always open. Or maybe you just need a touch from Jesus tonight. Maybe you need a touch in your body tonight. Go to God, maybe you need him to lift you up tonight, to encourage you. Let me tell you something, I ain't nothing special, but my Jesus is. And go to God, I know there's enough here tonight, and I've worked with these brothers, go to God, and I've prayed with them, I've laid on hands with others, on hands on others with them, and I've seen God move, amen. And I know, go to God, hallelujah, if you need a miracle tonight, there's enough faith in this house tonight that it can be believed for tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He can drive cancer out. Hallelujah. He can heal diabetes. He can heal high blood pressure. Whatever it may be, God can do it. By his stripes we were healed. My, he done paid the payment for it tonight. Hallelujah. If you have a need, come on up tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Many times trials, you see, we Word, your God, and the comfort of your word, your God. God help us to know your
attention. Man.
Everybody remember next week, it's Sister Angel. I'll be ministering. Amen.
Man.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Anybody got anything you want to say? Testimony or anything right down on their heart?
Good day, always a good service. We appreciate it.
Amen.
Thank the Lord.
Amen. We sure appreciate you coming out and being with us tonight. Amen. Anybody else?
Praise the Lord.
If not, keep us in your prayers tomorrow evening at 4 o'clock in the hospital. Again, come out and be with us. Next Saturday, 6 o'clock here at Sweetwater, 102 Mountain View Road, Sweetwater, Tennessee. Come out and be with us. Amen.
Amen.
Brother Stacy, dismiss us with a word of prayer.
Heaven, Father.